गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, हाउ आर यू? आई एम नवीन सर, योर मैथ्स टीचर ऑफ काकतिया पब्लिक स्कूल. यस्टरडे वी डिस्कस सम प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन अंडरस्टैंडिंग 3D एंड 2D शेप्स. टुडे वी विल रिवाइज दिस टोटल टॉपिक अंडरस्टैंडिंग 3D एंड 2D शेप्स. We will revise this topic, understanding 3D and 2D shapes. First, 2D shapes. The definition of 2D, the which objects have two dimensions, are length and breadth, are base and height, are called, such type of figures are called 2D shapes. Which objects have two dimensions like length and breadth or base and height are called 2D shapes. For example, square, rectangle, triangle, these are the etc. These are the examples of 2D shapes. Look at this again, square. So it has base and height. So how many dimensions it has? Square, two dimensions. So a square is a two-dimensional figure, 2D shape. Look at the figure. What is this? Rectangle. So a rectangle has a length and a breadth. So it is also two-dimensional figure. 2D shape. A rectangle is also a 2D shape. The two dimensions are length and breadth. What is this? Triangle. A triangle is also a 2D shape. So what are the two dimensions? This base and height. Perpendicular line segment joining from your vertex to its opposite side is called height, and this is a base. Base and height, two dimensions. So these are the examples of 2D shapes: square, rectangle and triangle. Now 3D shapes. Which objects have three dimensions? Length, breadth and height or depth. Such type of figures are called 3D shapes. So, which figures have length, three dimensions? The dimensions are length, breadth, height or depth. We will call as a height or depth. Both are same. So such type of figures are called 3D shapes. Examples for 3D shapes are cuboid, cylinder, cone, sphere, etc. Cone, see this, cube, cuboid, cylinder, cone, sphere, etc. These are all the 3D shapes. Now let us discuss about the 3D shapes. Cube. First, cube. So this is a diagram of cube. This is a diagram of cube. This is a 3D shape. It has a length and breadth and height. Length, breadth and height. So look at here, see length, breadth and this is a height. So, this is a cube. See, this is a 3D shape. It has a length. See, this is length. This is length and this is a breadth and it is a height. So it is a length, it is a breadth and it is a height. So here in square, all sides are equal. All edges are equal. All sides are equal. All sides are equal and a cube has a, all faces are squares. A cube has all faces are square faces. So it has a all faces are square faces. It has all faces are square faces. So cube. The cube is a three-dimensional figure. It has length, breadth, and height. All sides in cube, all sides are equal. It has a faces are all square faces. So here we have to identify the faces, edges, and vertices. So it has a, see, look at here, count the faces 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It has a 6 faces. A cube has a 6 faces and edges 1, 2, 3, 4. These are 4. Here 4 edges, top also 4 edges and lateral also 4 edges. 4, 4, 4. Total 12 edges. 12 edges. And now we have to count vertices. So vertices nothing but corners. At topmost 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 corners and down also 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 plus 4, 8 corners. Totally 8 vertices. So about cube, it has all sides are equal. It has all faces are square face. Faces, 6 faces, 12 edges and 8 vertices. Now, for example, cube. For example of cube, dice, ice cubes, chalk piece box. These are the examples of cube. Now next, cuboid. So look at the diagram of cuboid. This is a diagram of cuboid. So in cuboid, all edges are different. In cuboid, all edges are different, and a cuboid has a, all faces are rectangular faces. So look at that 3D shape. It is a cuboid. So here all edges are different. These edges are different, and all faces are rectangular faces. All faces are rectangular faces. So all sides are different. All sides are different, and all faces are rectangular faces. Rectangular faces. Now we have to identify the faces, edges, and vertices. So look at the 3D shape. Now we have to identify the faces. Front and back, two faces. Top and bottom, two faces. And here sides are two faces. 2, 4, 6. Total how many faces it has? 6 faces. Edges 4. Top 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 edges. And bottom also 1, 2, 3, 4 edges. 4 plus 4, 8. And lateral also 4 edges. 1, 2, 3, 4 edges. 4, 4, 4. Total 12 edges. And corners. At topmost of 1, 2, 3, 4. four corners and bottom also 1, 2, 3, 4. So bottom, top, 4, 4, total 8 corners, nothing but 8 vertices. So for cuboid, matchbox, eraser, these are the examples. And biscuit packet also is also example. So cuboid, all edges, all sides are different. All faces are rectangular faces. It has 6 faces, 12 edges and 8 vertices. And for a cuboid, matchbox and biscuit packet and eraser, duster, these are the examples of our daily life. Next, cylinder. Cylinder, let me draw the diagram of cylinder. So this is the diagram of cylinder, and look at this 3D shape cylinder. See the compare these two. Yes, a cylinder which rolls, it is called a curved surface area in the shape of rectangular shape. So a cylinder which rolls, it is in curved surface, we call it as a curved surface. It is in shape of rectangular shape and which stands vertically, so it's called as a base, is in plane surface, plane. It is in shape of circular shape. So here like this, if it stand vertically, so it is called as a base, base in plane surface. It is in circular shape, and which rolls, it is called as a curved surface. It is in rectangular shape. So here cylinder has a total 3 faces. Cylinder has a total 3 faces, which are 2 plane faces and 1 curved surface. Total 3 faces. The cylinder has a 3 faces and it has only 1 edge. So this is this. When we open this cylinder, it is we'll treat as a height. So this is called as the edge of a cylinder. It has only 1 edge. So here the cylinder does not have any vertex. So vertices are nil. The cylinder has vertices are nil. So it is a cylinder is a 3D object which rolls. It is called as a curved surface area, which stands vertically. It is called as a base. Base is in plane shape, plane surface. It is in circular shape. This is circular shape. It has a 3 faces and 1 edge. It has a nil vertices. It has no vertices. Next, cone. Cone. Let me draw a figure of cone. This is a diagram of cone. This is a diagram of cone. See, look at here. This is a cone which rolls. It is called as a curved surface area. It is in triangular shape. Which rolls. It is called as a curved surface area. So it is in triangular shape and which stands vertically. Its base is in plane surface. It is in circular shape. So it is in base is a circular shape, plane surface. Now it is a curved surface which rolls. It is in triangular face. So now identify the faces. So it has two faces. One is a curved surface and one plane surface. Two faces and edges. Edges. If we open this circular surface, then this it is called as slant height. We'll represent with the L. This L will count as an edge. We can treat as an edge. So it has only one edge and vertices. Vertices. So it has only one vertex at the topmost. Like here, this is a vortex. It has only one vortex. So a cone. Example, the figure of the cone. This is a 3D shape of cone, which roams. It is called curved surface, which stands vertically. It is a plane surface. It is in circular shape. It is in the curved surface in triangular face. It has a two faces, one edge and one vertex. Next, sphere. So look at here, sphere. This is the sphere. A sphere is a, look at the diagram of sphere here, like this. This is a diagram of sphere. It has only one surface. It has only one surface, that is a curved surface. It has only one surface. It is a curved surface. It is in circular shape. It is in circular shape. It has only one surface. So that is a curved surface. So faces, only one face. The sphere has a only faces, only one face. So it has an edges? No, it does not have edges. Plane surface, it has edges, but curved surface, no. The curved surface shapes are does not have edges. So edges are nil. And vertices, if we have plane surface, it has edges, then we can calculate the edges. But here it is a curved surface. The curved surface have no edges and no vertices. So here vertices also nil. Here vertex also nil. So here cylinder. Examples of cylinder: water tank, water bottle, chalk piece. These are the examples. And cone. For cone, conical vessel, mountain, and birthday cap. These are the examples of cone. Sphere. For sphere, cricket ball, volleyball, or basketball, or earth, laddus, gulab jamuns, rasgullas. These are the examples of sphere. Next, polygon. The definition of polygon: a simple closure figure formed by with at least three line segments is called a polygon. So the definition of polygon: a simple closure figure formed by with at least three line segments, then the simple closure figure is called as a polygon. So the polygons are many types. Based on the sides, we will name the polygon. If a polygon has three sides, then we will call the polygon is called as a triangle. So here, number of sides, name of polygon, name of polygon. So if a polygon has three sides, then the polygon will name as a triangle. If a polygon has four sides, then will name as a quadrilateral. If a polygon has five sides, then it is a pentagon. If a polygon has six sides, then it is a hexagon. If a polygon has seven sides, then it is a heptagon. If a polygon has eight sides, then it is a octagon. If a polygon has nine sides, nonagon. If a polygon has ten sides, that is a decagon. So like this, based on the size, we will name the polygon. Next, regular polygon. Regular polygon. The definition of regular polygon. If a polygon have all sides and angles are equal, then it is called as a regular polygon. In a polygon, all sides and angles are equal, then the polygon is said to be regular polygon. The examples of regular polygon are equilateral triangle and square and equilateral triangle, both are regular polygons. Why? Because look at the triangle. This is triangle. In this triangle, three sides are equal and three angles are also equal. Then the equilateral triangle is a regular polygon. Now look at this square. In square, all sides are equal and all angles are also equal. Then in a polygon, all sides are equal and all angles are equal. Then this polygon is square. Square is called as a regular polygon. In equilateral triangle, all sides are equal and all angles are equal. Then equilateral triangle is also example of a regular polygon. Next, prism. The definition of prism: a object with two parallel and congruent polygon faces, and lateral faces are parallelograms or rectangles, is called a prism. The definition of a prism: an object have two parallel congruent or parallel or congruent polygon faces, and lateral faces are rectangles or parallelogram, is called prism. So look at this triangular prism. So here these two are parallel, these two are like this parallel. So what is the polygon shape? Triangle. Here also triangle. So this is triangle and this is also triangle. So two congruent parallel polygon shape, and lateral faces are rectangular faces or parallelogram faces, is called a prism. So a prism is nothing but an object which have two parallel or congruent faces of polygon, and lateral faces are rectangles or parallelograms, is called as a prism. So if the parallel faces are triangle, then we will call as a triangular prism. If it is a triangle face, nothing but we will call as a triangle face, then we will call as a triangular prism. If it is a square face, then we will call as a square prism, like this. By the name of the polygon, we will name the prism: square prism, rectangular prism, triangular prism, pentagonal prism, hexagonal prism. Like this, we will name the prism. Next, pyramid. So now here, the definition of pyramid is an object, base is polygon shape, and lateral faces are triangular faces, then it is called as a pyramid. The definition of pyramid: base, an object with base is a polygon shape. An object base is a polygon shape, and lateral faces are triangular faces. Is called a pyramid. So look at this. Yes, base. Base is what? Polygon. What is a polygon? Square. And lateral faces are triangular faces. All are triangular faces. Then it is called as a pyramid. So base, same, based on the base of base which is polygon, using that name we will name the pyramid. Here it is a square, then we will name as a square pyramid. If base is rectangle, then it is a, we will name as a rectangular pyramid. If the base is triangle, then it will be called as a triangular pyramid. So here, this is like this, it is a square, base is polygon, and lateral faces are triangles, like this. So it is called as a square prism. Sorry, pyramid. Now let me draw the polygon is a rectangle shape. Then like this we will draw. This is called as a rectangular pyramid. So here also same like this. This is a square, and here also this is a square like this. So we have to join the lines for corresponding vertex. So these two here, like this, we have to join the vertex like this. So it is called as a square prism. Like this, we will call as a square prism, and like this, it is a rectangle. So this is also a rectangle. Now let us join the corresponding vertex here to here. Corresponding vertex. Here this corner to corresponding vertex, same like this corresponding vertex. Now it is called as a rectangular prism. Why? Because the polygon face is a rectangular face. See, two parallel congruent faces, these are, they are in rectangular shape. That's why we call as a rectangular prism. If here pyramid base is in square shape, then it is called as a square pyramid. Base is in rectangular shape, then we will call as a rectangular pyramid.